Yes, class, we are going to revise part 2 of Law Spring. Part 1 is done. So tomorrow you have test of the same chapter. And even you can get questions from other chapters also, which we have already revised. It does not mean ki kal ye hua to wahi aayega. Fine. The ones we have already revised, they can also come. So we have Mukesh is the protagonist, main character. Then narrator is also one of the characters. What is the name of the narrator? Yes, tell me. Anis Jung, correct. Fine. So you should know each and everything. Anis Jung is the name of the narrator. And she herself is present as one of the characters in both the parts. Part 2 is I want to drive a car. So the keywords of this chapter which you need to remember, Mukesh hails from Firozabad. Firozabad is known for bangle making. So bangle making is the major and prominent profession. You can say in each and every family, people make bangles of different colors, fine? And they are surviving on this profession only. There is no other professions which are, you can say, given priority. So at least 1-2 people, or you can say the whole family, is also involved in bangle making. So Firozabad is famous for that. So Mukesh hails from one such family in which he has all the members are involved in bangle making. Fine. Now the thing is, name of this main chapter is Lost Spring. That is spring season. You know that, known for rejuvenation. But he has lost his childhood in this. So that's why. But part 2 name is I want to drive a car. So he is different from rest of the boys and people in the society. There is a custom going on. Custom is that rigid, you can say, customs which are, nobody is going to change that. People just follow the family lineage of bangle making. So Mukesh is not like that. He wants to drive a car. But he is a very realistic dreamer. Ek to hota na that you start imagining the things that which are not beyond your reach. He is thinking that I want to drive a car, but he's not saying I'm going to own the car. I'm not going to buy the car. He wants to be a motor mechanic first. Okay. So he knew that by doing this, he will get a chance to drive a car. So that is the way. See, because he knows that they are in the vicious circle of poverty and they have to survive in the bangle making only. Mukesh's father has tried a number of professions. Then he ended up to bangle making only. Clear? So basically, what is there? Many people have turned blind either, or they lost their, you can say the eyesight is, they are not having good eyesight. They're not able to see at a distance. So that is due to, because the process of bangle making is very tedious, very difficult. Clear? Because people lose their eyesight. They have to sit in the darkness firstly, in the dingy rooms. They are not at all rich, those who are having luxurious rooms and all. So they are having dingy cells in the same room. They are having their kitchen also. Everything is there and they are making bangles and they have to concentrate on the light in that darkness. That leads to impact their eyesight. Okay, you have come today, but don't talk. So that is the basic, you can say, thing in this chapter. Rest of the points are there. So kindly note down some value points, beta, for yourself only, for your preparation. First of all, write down Firozabad is famous for making bangles. These key points will help you to revise the concepts. During the exams, all the chapters will be there. You might get confused, okay, whether they're talking about Mukesh or whether they're talking about Sahib-e-Alam. Sahib-e-Alam is the one who scrounges garbage, fine? So I have seen many students, they intermix the characters also. So please, Lord of the Universe is the name, meaning of name of Sahib, that we have done that day. So today we are doing this character, Mukesh. So Firozabad is famous for bangle making. Every family is engaged in making bangles. Families have spent generations working on the bangle making only. Clear? So welding off, and you know, all the women in the family, they are also involved. Those who have to wear bangles, they are making bangles also. So none of them, they know that it is illegal for children like Mukesh. This is illegal, that when children are involved in such tedious tasks where they can end up their lives. But even then they have, you know, for poor people, they have more children, means more working hands for them. So they are engaging all their children, women, men in the profession of bangle making only. So they have, next is they have glass, you can say furnaces with high temperatures. The kind of atmosphere they are working, that is glass furnaces with high temperatures. So that is very dangerous for the kids. In dingy cells, when there is, where there is no air, no light, very, you can say, concise in space, where they can just sit and work, right? No air, no light, dingy cells, and they slog their daylight hours. This is metaphorical meaning. Slogging their daylight hours means they are just, the whole day is spent in bangle making. They have not done anything else in their lives. Fine. And they often losing the brightness of their eyes. Then there are almost Mukesh and almost 20,000 children who are working in this bangle making. Fine. More than 20,000 children. So they walk down stinking lanes chalked with garbage. Their homes, you know, Mukesh will be taking narrator also into the homes in very excited way. When narrator meets Mukesh, Mukesh will be showing her the path to his home. And then they have mentioned the kind of path, which is very stinky. Fine means kafi smell aa raha hai, wahan se garbage dumps can be seen. And there are crumbling walls. They can fall at any time. Crumbling doors and no windows, please. No windows. So humans and animals coexist over there. They have no separate spaces for animals. Clear? Then they enter a half-built shack where Mukesh is residing. And they are using dead grass to make a thatch. Jo rooftop ke upar wo shed dalte hain. Fine, in that way. So a frail young woman is cooking evening meal over a firewood stove. They do not have facility of gas and all. They use firewood. And that woman actually belongs to Mukesh's family, the wife of his brother, his elder brother. So when narrator and Mukesh enter his home, they see a young woman building, you can say cooking meal. And then other rest of the members are, there are, you can say she cooks food for three men in the family, for her husband, for her father-in-law and Mukesh himself. So she's busy in that. She's the wife of Mukesh's brother and already she's doing all the household chores all alone. The father is a very poor bangle maker. In spite of many years of hard work, he ended up in bangle making. Fine. So he's unable to send his sons to school and he could just teach them the art of bangle making, nothing else. He could not afford to send them to school. Fine. So that's why Mukesh and his brother both are uneducated. Clear? Mukesh's grandmother. Then there is important character in this chapter, because grandmother has represented the that face of society in which people are God-fearing, people who believe in karma, people who are, you know, those who think that whatever is given to them in the family lineage, it should be followed. Clear? There are many dialogues of the grandmother of Mukesh, which will tell us that she is representing such women in the society. Clear? So grandmother is there. Mukesh's grandmother, she has watched her own husband go blind with the dust from polishing. The dust which is used in the bangle making, which is like scattering over when they make the bangles. Lot of polish and dust is there in the air. Clear? So glass of bangles, she says that it is his destiny. She implies that God-given lineage can never be broken. They have been born in the caste of bangle makers and they have seen nothing else. When they were born, when they were being raised up, they have seen spirals of bangles in the piles, in the streets, in the courtyard, in the rooms, everywhere. Clear? So they are having huttments only, flames only, flickering lamps all around. This is their destiny. And then they have mentioned a minor character also. Her name is Savita. Please get up. So Savita, she is sitting beside her grandmother. Fine. and she is wearing drab pink dress. Actually, she is representing all the girls in that society, those who once in a while lifetime will be getting married and will be wearing those bangles. But those who do not know the importance, because bangles, they have with, okay, you tell me, what do the bangles represent? Yes, marriage. Yes, that she is a married woman. It doesn't mean an unmarried girl can also wear bangles, but the times she was born in and the time she is being raised, bangles means it is a sign of married women. So she is making bangles. She's so innocent, doesn't know the meaning of bangles even here. So she is sitting beside an elderly woman. She's also soldering the pieces of glass, which is very difficult. And her hands are moving mechanically. Children are trained in a mechanical way, jaise machines chalti hain. So they are sitting and doing one task in a mechanical manner. And the old woman beside her, now they talk about the poverty. That old woman who's sitting with Savita and making bangles, she says that she has not even enjoyed one full meal in her lifetime. After doing so much hard work, ek time ka khana bhi acche se nahi khaya. They are having meals, but they are not either having a good meal or it is not that that they are able to fill up their stomachs. They are getting meager amounts. So she has mentioned that, okay, that not even once she has got a good meal. Fine. And mechanically they are moving their hands and the girl also helping. Then after that, they are having the sufficient, you can say, or just basic amenities of life they are facing. Karthik, you're talking. So they have, then after that, Bita, they are talking about that young men of Firozabad, they are also following the family lineage. And very important concept, jiske upar bahut bar question aaya hai. That is middlemen and sahukars of Firozabad. Who are the middlemen? Those who are responsible. They are going to work. Why they are known as middlemen? They worked in between sahukars and the poor people who arrange money for them, or they do not, you know, convey there, because they're uneducated. People are uneducated, illiterate. So they, whatever middlemen ask them to do or sahukars are forcing them to do, they do that. Aapko yaad aa jata hai ki main class mein hoon na 2 minute ke baad. Again. So be at home, those who are, you know, they have attended classes at home, those who are not at all in habit of listening. They are the faces who regularly come to school. Aap piche chale jao please. Nahi, go at last. Ab kuch rahi nahi kya, chapter hi ho gaya pura. Last desk, can please Samyak sit properly. What's his name? I hope. Yes, Saksham. So then, yes, beta. Middlemen and sahukars, they have trapped, actually, beta, listen, I'm saying this is very important from the board's point of view, I'm talking to you. This question was there in the consecutive in many years when subjective papers were there. That why did not people of Firozabad organize themselves into cooperative? Note down. Aaya tha na, because this is the base of this chapter, that they are in the stuck, ye sabko pata hai, that they are stuck in the vicious circle of poverty, bangle making is there, blind ho gaye and all, they are the basic things. Now the root cause, that why they are stuck in the bangle making, why they are not improving their state. So that's why do not people of Firozabad make their own cooperative. Cooperative societies hoti hain, those who can, you know, show their unity together and they can make their own cooperative groups to raise their voice against the wrong things done to them. So why? Yes, Gaurav? So you are having vague information, half information, fine. Now the thing is, actually years of mind-numbing toil means hard work, they have put in efforts, their fathers and forefathers all are stuck in the vicious circle of middlemen and sahukars, and then they try their level best that these people of Firozabad, innocent people of Firozabad, should not come out of this vicious circle. What is the motion of a circle? Circle has no end, it goes on and on. So they have made sure that these people will stuck in the circular motion. उनके ऊपर इंटरेस्ट लगा लगा के उनका इतना ज्यादा, मींस दे आर बर्डन अंडर द सिस्टम ओनली एंड दे कैन नॉट टर्न देमसेल्व्स इनटू कोऑपरेटिव बिकॉज द रीजन, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बेटा, पे अटेंशन टू द रीजन व्हाई डू नॉट दे मेक कोऑपरेटिव्स, दे कैन बी हॉल्ड अप बाय द पुलिस. आई एम यूजिंग द न्यू वर्ड हियर, हॉल्ड अप, एच ए यू एल ई डी, दे कैन बी हॉल्ड अप बाय द पुलिस. Means they can be caught by the police in simple language. Fine, number one. This is the first reason. They can be beaten by the police and dragged into jail. First fear they are having of the police. Clear? And secondly, there is no leader among them. No one is ready to be the leader. Then no one helps them to see things differently because there is no leader. No one will help them to see the things differently. Whatever is going on, it will go on. All of them, they talk of poverty and injustice, but there is no one who can raise voice for them. So all are scared actually that if they raise their voice, they will be trapped into the other system, which is not already, they are suffering a lot of problems. So aur kyun create karenge? So they are scared of turning themselves into a cooperative. Clear hai ye question? I am asking. Kaun se wale? Nahi, aap statement dhyan se padhna ya apna chapter dhyan se padhna. No, if such thing is there, all key option will be provided to you. If all correct, fine. You might not have, I have not seen the question that you are talking about. Maybe there is always a cue in the statement or in the options. Dhyan se apne question padhna, fine. So secondly, yes beta, clear. So two distinct worlds are visible, fine. Two distinct worlds. One is, yes beta, two different concepts here. First, they are stuck into the poverty and burdened up with the stigma of caste in which they are born, of bangle making, fine. One is this problem. Second is the vicious circle of, write down, money lenders, middlemen, policemen. I repeat, on the other hand, they are stuck in the vicious circle of money lenders, middlemen, policemen, and the keepers of law and politicians. Keepers of law and politicians. So a child naturally accepts what his father is doing. Itna pressure hai that a child is not thinking of doing something else. But when we talk about this, Mukesh, he dares to be different than others. He wants to be a motor mechanic. He wants to drive a car. Fine. And at the end, they have mentioned a few planes fly over Firozabad. Very important. Write down. What is the metaphorical meaning to this? A few planes fly over Firozabad. Yes, you tell me. Raise your hands, whatever you understand out of this.